just this September they've issued another admission notice for the year 2019 and 20, and again they have refused to follow reservations. Although the IIM Act grants autonomy to IIMs, they are not free to violate the law of the land, and as far as the law of land is concerned, they have to implement reservation in their doctoral programs. In December 2017, the Indian Parliament passed the IIM Act. The IIM Act designated all the IIMs as national institutes of importance and also made them central education institutions. What that means is the Central Education Institute Act also applies to IIMs now. All the central education institutions, which includes IIMs also now, have to implement reservations in their academic programs for candidates belonging to scheduled castes, scheduled tribes, other backward classes. After the act was passed, most of the IIMs advertise their admission notice that they'll be implementing reservations. IIM Ahmedabad refused to follow the act. The first argument that IIM Ahmedabad makes is that because they don't receive any funding from Government of India, they are not obliged to follow reservations. Well, first of all, it's factually untrue. As we show in our EPW paper, IIM Ahmedabad has received in the recent years funding for their FPM program. Second of all, an institute may not be for a particular year receiving funding, but over a period of time, IIM Ahmedabad has been built based on government funds, and they can't just choose not to follow a law. Second argument that IIM Ahmedabad makes is that the FPM program is a very specialized program. The FPM program in IIM Ahmedabad is no more specialized, or the PhD program now in IIM Ahmedabad is no more specialized than a PhD program in electrical engineering or aeronautical engineering or aerospace engineering in Indian Institute of Science, which has to follow reservation as part of the same act. Things that led to the death of Rohit Vemmula, those things were not even started talking about as far as IIMs are concerned. It was that event which made a lot of us look at the educational environment within higher educational institutes in India. As I looked around, I realized that most of my colleagues, most of the fellows at IIM Bangalore belonged to just one caste. They were all Brahmins. As we started exploring more, we started filing RTAs at various IIMs, and to our utter shock, we figured out that across 13 IIMs out of over 500 faculties, only 2 belong to scheduled castes, scheduled tribes. We also found that 1/3 of all the faculties were actually recruited from the FPM program of the IIMs itself. And IIMs were not, most of the IIMs at that point were not implementing reservations. So because of lack of reservations at the doctoral level, there were not enough candidates at the level of faculty. And that's why we started focusing on reservations at the level of the doctoral program. If you look at the level of exclusion that our data shows, there are a lot of parallels with the conditions that existed in apartheid South Africa.